Today I'm going to do a logo design challenge video. I'm going to have AI generate a company name, and I will design a logo for that company in less than 15 minutes using Adobe Illustrator. So let's start a 15-minute timer. All right, so first I'm going to go to ChatGPT and type in create a list of surf company names. And let's see what it comes up with. I am going to simply choose one of the names in this list to design the logo from. Okay, it's coming up with a lot. I'm just going to go to the top 10 and see what I like the best. Salt Wave. I really like Salt Wave. That makes me just think of salty water and maybe a wave icon of some kind. So I think I'm going to just go with that. Okay, so I'm going to go over to Adobe Illustrator to get started on this and just say new file. And let's just type in our company name, Salt Wave. Make it a little bigger. Okay, so before we get started, I want to do a little bit of visual research in Google. That's usually the first place I start when I begin a logo project. So let's go just type in wave icons and just see what kind of waves that Google can show me. I love just kind of getting lots of different ideas, seeing what styling I really like. So I'll look at more images. And if there's anything I really love, I'm going to copy it over into my file so we can use it as visual inspiration. I'm really liking these. Another tip, just so you get high res images, is you can go in Google Images, you can go to the tools, go to size, and just find large images. Okay, so Salt Wave. I definitely want a wave in this, and I'm trying to think if there's some additional layer or something that could make it feel salty. Although for this challenge, I might need to go with something a little flatter. This is kind of interesting. It has some like lines inside of it. I think I'm just going to copy this into my file just for some visual inspiration. Make it smaller. I'm not sure if I'm going to use that yet, just so we can reference it later. Ooh, these are kind of fun. That kind of makes me think of a more of a splash than a wave though. So let's just keep going. Not seeing exactly what I'm hoping to see. I was kind of looking for another like two-dimensional wave that has lines in it. That is maybe a little more complex than this. Ooh, this is really cool. I really like three shapes here. So I'm gonna copy this into my file. Okay, so those are similar. They've got like some similar shapes going on. Let's just focus on this icon first, and then I'm going to get into typography and then arranging the two. I'm really liking this probably better than this. There's an awesome feature in Adobe Illustrator called Image Trace, and it allows you to take an image and essentially like trace it into a vector shape. So I'm going to use Image Trace and just see what I come up with. Okay, nothing. So we need to adjust our image trace settings. Okay, I just adjusted the threshold here and it actually made it show up. This is really a pretty good result. So I'm gonna click expand. And you know what, while we're at it, let's just image trace this one too. Change the threshold. Let's see what we get there. Okay, I'll expand that one too. All right, I really like this concept though. And I might just add some additional lines like this up here to this one. So I'm gonna drag this over. This one, probably not gonna use. I'm gonna take it off our artboard for now. Okay, I'm just gonna see if I can add a couple lines to this, maybe this first one, just to see if that adds a little bit more dimension and makes it a little more interesting. Okay, so I'm gonna use the pen tool and really just add some white lines here and see if I can come up with a nice shape that I like just in black and white before we start adding colors. And maybe I need like one more line here. I don't know. Something like that is kind of interesting. And I like that there's just a little bit of extra dimension to this wave. So we're just going to go with this. Just a side note, I love working in black and white initially when it comes to logo design. I think that color can kind of get in the way. I always like to get the forms looking great in black and white, and then I add color later. So let's make this a little bigger. And I'm just going to start looking through some fonts. I have a lot of fonts that are already installed on my computer that could probably work for this. I'm probably looking for a sans serif font, something a little more modern that kind of goes with a surf culture. Ooh, that one's kind of nice. Salt Wave. Okay, let's try a few different fonts, see what we can come up with. And my process is really, I just start scrolling through all my fonts and just trying a whole bunch of different ones. I look at them on the page and see what's working. I could also try this in all caps. I don't know if all caps will work or not here. Okay, so this font is actually an all caps font. Okay, so I've got three fonts here. Let's just start to pair this. And this mark that I've come up with is really horizontal. So I think just keeping my type horizontal underneath this mark might be perfect. I actually really like that first font. I'm gonna essentially just copy and paste this a few times and try the different fonts, see how they feel. Okay, so I probably need to make it bigger. I kind of like that this W is sort of interacting with the lines above it. I think I prefer the all caps. I wonder if I could make this one all caps. Always want to do optical spacing on my letters. And I'm not really getting into like kerning and that kind of thing just yet. Let's try this other font that I found. And I think I've already decided I like all caps the best under this shape. Let's make this one all caps also. Okay, so out of the three, I still probably like this top one the best. I'm gonna also make this optical. I do think this wave is, right now it's kind of competing with the type. I wonder if I need to add some additional lines or something, so I might try that quickly. We're gonna eliminate these for now. I'm just gonna drag them over here. So we're just working with the one that we like. And I'm also gonna drag this type off my artboard. Let me just see if adding a couple additional lines to this might help just kind of separate it a little bit. I wonder, like, if I attach them to the waves, how that will feel. And then maybe one beneath it, and maybe making that type the same width. That's headed somewhere. Okay, so the last step is I'm gonna start adding some color. Usually I would find a color palette, but for right now I'm just going to start using my color picker and try a few things. So I'm going to go to window color so I kind of get the full color of the rainbow. And I'm thinking like a pretty light color. And sometimes I like to do little swatches. I actually don't mind like the black and the blue. That's kind of cool. I do think having these two waves that are a little farther in the background be a slightly lighter color potentially might be kind of nice. And let me just make my other swatch here. And I wouldn't mind this also being blue. Let's see. Maybe even like a darker blue. Yeah, maybe I just use like three blues in this design. I don't know. And lastly, I think I want this wave to be the same color as this. So it could be something like this. All right, so here's our logo that I came up with in this session. And our timer is just now going off. This is a logo design that I created in 15 minutes. Obviously, it's not perfect. I would love to keep going on this just to show you how my process kind of looks. This is usually how I work in Illustrator. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial today. Be sure to check out my video on creative process and also have a video on logo design. And follow CryStudio for more graphic design and Adobe Illustrator tutorials. Thanks so much.